Well, this is the side that everybody's been waiting for. HMS Bulwark inching her way home back into Devonport. She's been away for 3 months. Initially, she travelled to commemorate the Gallipoli 100th anniversary and then was due to do an exercise with the US off the coast of Morocco. But it was at that point that the world started to hear about the terrible tragedy that was unfolding in the Mediterranean. Bulwark and her crew were re-rolled. They went out on the hunt for migrants crammed into those dreadful boats and rescued nearly 5,000 of them. They're working with personnel from 4-5 Commando and also Merlin helicopters from Chivna. So it's been quite a journey, and what stories these people have got to tell. A real sign of how capable and versatile the Royal Navy can be. But today, really, it's all about the families and the crew being reunited. There'll be that moment later when they come down that gangplank. But let's take a look at the crowds, because there are hundreds of them here, accompanied by the band of the Coldstream Guards. Brilliant musical accompaniment. Sign saying, "Welcome home, Daddy. Lewis, ahoy. Colonel Cornwall welcomes you back." All of these signs are here. And let's go and speak now with one member of the crowd who is waiting patiently for us over here. Laura Chivers, thanks for talking to us. Hiya. Tell us who you're waiting for.
We're waiting for Daddy, Rob Chivers.
And he's been away for the whole 3 months?
Yes, he has.
First of all, what's it been like for you folks as a family that Daddy's been away?
It's hard work. It's harder not knowing when they're coming back, but we are proud of them. All of them, the whole company, so we just can't wait to have them home.
And of course they've been doing sterling work in the Mediterranean. Your thoughts on that?
I'm glad they're helping. Really glad. I would hate to think that no one's helping, but I am glad to have them back. But they are going back in September, so we'll see what happens.
Then. Are you looking forward to having Daddy back?
Yeah.
Have you missed him? Well, it won't be long now. The ship's coming in. Lauren and family, thank you very much indeed. Enjoy the reunions. He's missed his daddy. Everybody here has missed loved ones. And soon, if we take a look, HMS Bulwark will be here alongside in Devonport. There you can see her crew lining the flight deck. What a proud moment for them. Homecomings are always special, but this one has so much more extra resonance because of the wonderful work they've all been doing in the Mediterranean. They truly have been saving lives, almost on an industrial scale. More from here through the day on Forces TV, but for now from me, Tim Cooper, this is Tim Cooper reporting in Devonport for Forces TV.
So, first of all, back on dry land in Plymouth, how does that feel?
It feels wonderful, Becky. We're delighted to be back. It's been a very long 3 months, very intense. We've been busy pretty much for all of it. There's been very little respite. It wasn't the deployment that we set out for. And of course, when you go for 7 weeks, then you have that date in your mind. We've been extended for almost twice that amount of time. It's been very hard work. We've been worked hard as well, which we like doing, but we're now ready for a bit of a break.
And summing up the mission as such, I understand that you rescued almost 5,000 people.
Yeah, 4,747, it's a huge number of people in what was effectively 6 weeks on task. When we set out, we knew that this was a tragic circumstance where there were an awful lot of people going out to sea, losing their lives, but we didn't really know how many people we were actually going to see once we got there and what we were going to find by way of each rescue. Every rescue has been different. Sometimes it's been hundreds, sometimes up to over 1,000 at any one go. But I think to have recovered, saved the lives of 4,747 people in that amount of time is testament to the extraordinary work that my ship's company have done over the last six weeks.
And it must have been as well quite challenging for them at times.
It was challenging, and for the most part, it was getting used to the environment, getting used to what we were actually up against, and making sure that the concepts of operations, the way in which we're going to go about our business, was actually right for the task. And of course, on each occasion, we adjusted those, we made them better, improved them where they needed to be improved. But actually, I think we've conducted it superbly. One of the key things was to make sure that we always improved the situation. A lot of danger out there, and if we'd ever incurred an injury, if we'd ever lost someone, then I would have seen that as a real failing. On every occasion, we've sustained no injuries, no deaths, and always allowed people to leave the ship in an improved condition. So that's great.
And now we're back in Plymouth. What's next for your ship and your ship's company?
Well, we're straight into a period of maintenance. One of the things that that has come with the fact that we're extended is that our program has been a little bit compressed. So we're straight into a period of very important maintenance over the next couple of months. We're going to take a bit of leave. Some of the ship's company have got some courses to take, and then we're working up again in September to head back to the Mediterranean at the end of September.